in this video, I want to look at the leading cause of disabilities worldwide. In the last 25 years, according to a research team, a fascial research team, lower back pain has doubled. And this can be due to our sedentary way of living. Often when we look at a short-term solution, it will either be medication or an operation. But today I want to look at our sedentary way of living. Often we sit for long periods of time, which our work calls for. So we're shortening these muscles in the front line of our body, and we're overextending these muscles in the back line of our body. We have a muscle that sits within the deep core line, the psoas muscle. It's connected to the iliacus muscle, and in the front we have the iliopsoas. So you can see the connection between the front and the back line of the body. Today what I want to do with you is I want to lengthen and stretch these muscles in the front line of the body and just release those muscles in the back line of the body. We have a thick band of fascial tissue from the thoracic spine, the base of the thoracic spine, called the thoracolumbar junction. The thoracolumbar junction runs from that vertebra along to the quadratus lumborum on either side of the spine and down into the sacrum. So it's a diamond shape. And when we sit and we're in these sedentary postures for a long period of time, this thick band of fascial tissue dehydrates. So when we move, the connective tissue that makes up the fascial tissue hydrates, and the fluid, the interstitial fluid, as well as the cerebrospinal fluid that flows up and down the spine, creates movement in the lower back. So that stiffness that we feel when we often have been sitting for long periods of time, we should keep moving and keep hydrating. So we're looking at those spiral movements, those rounding of the spine, the roll downs, those kind of things, to really hydrate that thick band of fascial tissue. So what we're going to be using today is one of these resistance bands. You're going to need to make a loop in it. So you can either tie a knot or loop it over and then just tie a knot that way. And we've got a few options here. If you have one of these high-density myofascial peanuts, this is a great lightweight tool that we can use to release that lower back area. The other option is these reflex balls, the soft reflex balls with the nodules. If you don't have those, you can also use two tennis balls. So something fairly soft that we're able to put on either side of the spine and on the spine. Okay, so starting off in a seated position, I'm going to use this myofascial peanut, roll down through the spine. Let's bring the tailbone into a lifted position and bring the peanut or those two balls onto either side of the spine. So we have two dimples on either side of the spine at the line of the hip bones. So this is the iliac crest, and we're going to position the peanut or the two balls on either side of the spine in those dimples. Here, as I mentioned, we need to look at the breathing. So we're going to arch. You're creating space within the diaphragm, so I want you to breathe into the space and breathe out. And release. Again, a nice deep breath in and breathe out and release. And breathe out and release. And breathe out and release. Do another two, and breathe out, and release, and another one, and breathe out, fish in the peanut or those two balls right along the spine. Position it slightly higher up so the base or the lower ball is on the line of the hip bones. And again, we're just arching and tucking. Breathing in and out. So what we want to look at doing is opening up between the spaces in the vertebra. If anyone is familiar with sciatica, you'll know that that nerve is connected to the spine in this area here. So often when that sciatic nerve is damaged or is pinched between those vertebra, it can cause a lot of pain down the leg. So what we want to do is open up the vertebra in the spine and allow those nerves to move freely. Now just keep the pelvic tilt, so tuck the tailbone under, and just a small rocking motion from side to side. Now push the pelvis up into a lifted position, roll down through the spine, hug your knees into the chest, roll yourself up off the mat, and come into a nice lifted position. Now we're going to come forward onto the front, onto our front. You can use the peanut, or if you have one of the reflex balls, we're just going to use one of the reflex balls. Lower down onto your front, position the ball into the palm of your hand, and you're going to bring the ball inside the hip bone. So where the diaphragm sits, I want you to bring it inside the diaphragm. Where the hip bone is, not on the bone, but inside the bone. And you're going to wiggle the hips from side to side. We just want to work into the diaphragm just to release that diaphragm. If you have the peanut, you can just bring one side of it into the, and then just wiggle from side to side. Now position the ball or the peanut underneath the hip bone into that hip flexor. Come up onto your elbows and I want you to rock forward and back. So we're lengthening and stretching that psoas, that iliopsoas muscle. Let's do the same thing to the other side. Position that peanut inside the hip bone and relax your forehead on your hand and just wiggle the hips from side to side, releasing the diaphragm. Now position the peanut underneath the hip bone on that iliopsoas. Come up onto your elbows, curl your toes under, and roll up and down, releasing that front line. Now that iliopsoas muscle, it is connected to those quadricep muscles in the front of the legs. So often, if this muscle is tight, you're going to feel quite a lot of tightness in the, just above the knee and up the front of the thighs. Let's come onto the hands and knees. Release the balls or the peanut. Hands under the shoulders. And now we're going to focus on the breathing. So I want you to round your spine. And as you round your spine, tuck your chin to your chest. Push into your fingertips. So you're almost trying to slide your hands forward on the mat. So the more you do that, the more you're going to feel those abdominal muscles activate. Breathe out as you do this. Now from the tailbone, I want you to arch and push into the heels of the hands. Breathe in. Push the heels of the hands into the mat as if you're trying to slide the hands up towards the knees. And again, you'll feel that activation in the abs. Breathe out. Round the spine. So you're causing a lot of movement in that lower back, opening up into the vertebra and breathing out as you do that. And then breathing in, arching from the tailbone, pushing into the heels of the hands and breathing in. And breathe out. Breathe in. And again, breathe out. And breathe in. And breathe out. From here, we're going to lower down onto the abdominal muscles again. Just relax your forehead and your hands and wiggle your hips from side to side. Now in this next position, if you can take the feet, both of the feet into the hands, do so. If you can't, do both sides, one side. If you can do both sides, we're going to focus again on the breathing. Engage your glutes to support the lower back. And the only thing that's going to lift you off the mat into a seesaw motion is your breathing. Bring the hands underneath the shoulders, push back up, and going into your child's pose. If you are taking strain in that position, then rather focus on one foot at a time into the hand and focus on squeezing and activating the glutes. Come back onto hands and knees. Come into a seated position. Now for this next release, we're going to use that loop that we made and bring it around the ball of the foot, bring it slightly lower onto the arch of the foot as well, just so it doesn't come off the top of the foot. Now in this position, I want you to rotate your foot so the foot is pointing towards the opposite shoulder. Take the resistance band in the opposite hand and bounce your leg over. Now you'll feel a nice lateral stretch and a hamstring stretch. This will also stretch into that thoracolumbar junction, so into that lower back. So just a nice release. Then we're going to rock the leg from side to side. Pull the leg across the body. Look away from the direction you are going with the leg. Just get a nice stretch into that lower back area. And release. Pull the band towards you and just bounce into that stretch. Nice hamstring stretch, nice hamstring release into the calf, that back line of the body. Now we're going to keep the band around that leg. Reach the opposite arm next to the ear. And you're going to take a nice deep breath in. And as you breathe out, coming into a nice rotation there. So we're working into those muscles and that thick band of fascial tissue in the lower back, that thoracolumbar junction. Breathe in and breathe out. Nice deep breath in. Let's keep going, another four, and breathe out, and three, and breathe out, two, and breathe out, and the last one. Hold it in that rotation and bounce the arms, reach to the toes, then beyond, and then elbow into that rotation, four, three, two, one, take hold of that foot and just increase that stretch. Pull that band around, pull the elbow into that rotation. Let's repeat this to the other side. Breathing in, And let's come into that lift and then we'll finish off with a stretch. Rotate with the elbow. Breathe in and lower down. Breathe out. Breathe in and lower down. Another four. And three. For two. And one. Hold it and rotate. For two. Reach. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. And eight. Good. Lower down. Leg stays up. And let's just pull that leg towards the same shoulder. Let's take that leg into the band, into the opposite hand. Rotate the foot to point towards the opposite shoulder. And bounce that leg across. So we're looking at the hamstring and the leg stretch for now. Now let's bring the toes facing forward and you can rock over to the opposite side. And then just hold it. If there is a lot of tension and a lot of stiffness in that back, you want to make the movement small to start with and keep moving into it. Don't hold that static stretch. Focus on a nice dynamic stretch to hydrate the fascial tissue. Make the movement slow and controlled. And then when you have eased those muscles into the stretch and that fascial tissue is hydrated, bring the leg right across the body. Let's release the band. Those hip flexors feeling a little bit tight now. Let's have a good stretch and yawn. Yawning is amazing to release those somatotem, those muscles in the jawline. And bring your feet flat. Take a nice deep breath in. Roll up off the mat. Push your pelvis up. And just stretch into those hip flexors and breathe. Loosen up the neck, if there's any tension there. Roll down through the spine. Hug your knees into your chest. Rock yourself up into a seated position. And hopefully, you're feeling like you have a little bit more movement in that lower back, in that thoracolumbar junction. Hold on to the knees, just round the spine and give it a good stretch. Feet flat side by side, walk your hands to your feet and just hang out there. This is a nice movement to open up between the vertebra and breathe in. Focus on that posture, pulling the shoulder blades together, getting a nice stretch into the front of the hip, engaging the glutes.